automatic death cure in a while. Aquarius. Yeah. Constellation. Holy Spirit, would you link me up with the soul cycle of Aquarius? Should our Aquariuses be aware of their Holy Spirit? We have in the heart of the matter for Aquarius. This one? Okay. 8 of Wands. Something coming in really quick. I'm going to pull another one on that one, though. This could be messages, emails or something like that coming in quick. Could be arrows of love too, but let's see what's coming in quick. Five of Swords, Lord of Defeat. So quick coming in. Doesn't have to be defeat. This one sometimes means like just real cruelty. Somebody's coming in to do something cruel, or you could be doing something cruel to somebody else really quick. Sometimes this means like humiliation too. Like not just defeat, but like, you know, kicking somebody while they're down type shit. So be cautious of that. Quick coming in too, it's a bad combination. It's cruelty, swiftly coming in. Cruelty is the heart of the matter. What do we got in the challenge? Is a Queen of Pentacles. Queen of the Thrones of the Earth, so a possible Earth sign, usually could be male or female. Usually pretty abundant in charge of their finances, like material things, like sometimes nature, like they like to go up into nature and touch things, like. And they're like hands on, they like material things, like can also be like represent like security, like be protected. What do we got in subconsciously? What is Aquarius thinking? Subconsciously, another five, man. Thinking of a high priestess, somebody who's very knowledgeable in the occult. This could be you, possibly. Somebody who's very knows a lot of hidden things, knows how to go within, like that, and gain whatever knowledge she wants from the universe, right? Balance to emotions, balance is like yin yang, dark and light, balancing both, walking the tightrope. And I don't know, Five of Wands, this is like conflict. So yeah, definitely got some kind of conflict. Your part of the situation is like quick coming in, like somebody come in quick and do something nasty. And subconsciously, you're already thinking about it. Or you're thinking about it, maybe it's already happened. It's also Leo energy. Could fire. This is just like conflict. Could be competing or something with somebody. I don't know. 2 fives, though, that's easy when you get that many fives right off the bat. It's like, somebody could be doing something I hate to say it because I don't want to sound like whatever, but I don't know when I get that too many two fives right off the bat like that. Fives are just temporary though, right? They don't last. But it's usually somebody doing some kind of rituals or some shit like that, you know what I mean? Or you could just be having a really, really bad day. Or have a lot of haters, you know what I mean? So, what do we got in the past? It was the Queen of Cups in the past, so. Water sign, nurturing side of feelings, Queen of the Thrones of the Water. So, could be Cancerian energy, Scorpionic energy, Cancer, Scorpio, maybe. Yeah, it's got the crab. Yeah, so that's in the past, you know, so that's not really a water sign, most likely, though. Male or female. What have we got in the present for us? Aquarius. Aquarius. In the present. Okay. So, presently, you've got... Lord of Ten of Pentacles. So, cha-ching, cha-ching. That's nice. You got generational wealth in your present. So, that's good. That's really good. You got a Princess of Cups. So, Princess of the Palace of the Floods is like, this could mean like, being like in your, like daydreaming kind of. Daydreaming a bit. Which is good. The daydream kind of. That's how some people meditate, right? And just by letting them. Thoughts wander wherever the hell they want, right? So, Seven of Wands, the Lord of Valor. So, I think I'm gonna look that one up, but I think that's like probably to do with this conflict here. Whatever the heck that is, watch for that, because that's like quick coming in, like it's on you before you even know what the hell happened, it looks like. Quick coming in, cruelty, defeat. Doesn't mean defeat though. It means like somebody, whoever's coming in to do that is trying to humiliate you and do it really fast. It's just like a real brutal maneuver, right? It could be like, doesn't even have to be like violent though. Like it could literally mean like some fucking drunk asshole like running through your yard and grabbing your pink flamingo and being ha ha and running away with it, you know what I mean? It could be something like that, you know? Mars in Leo, so that's Leo energy too. So there's a lot of Leo in your chart here. Leo, victory, valor, advantage, gain, overcoming opposition. Okay, so you're gonna, this is in the future, so you're gonna overcome whatever the hell this little skirmish is somebody brought to your doorstep here. No, that's in the present moment. So yeah, presently you're overcoming that. So it'll be over as quick as it starts, whatever the hell that is. Maybe the guy stole your pink flamingo out of your front yard. Maybe you just happen to have a lawn dart beside you. Right it up, right between the shoulder blades. Pin him to the front lawn and get your pink flamingo back, right? Yeah. You only use one of those. What do we got in the future for our Aquarius? Two or these three? Okay. Yeah, I'm taking these three. So in the future you got a magician, two of swords, so you're gonna have to make a choice because you're gonna be at the stalemate. So you're gonna have to make a choice. possibly between the Lord of Despair and Cruelty. That's like being in your head and stuff. Nightmares. That's a good thing to be. It could be like PTSD from the Flamingo Long Dart incident, right? Magician, Two of Swords. Yeah, so you're going to have to make some kind of you're going to be at a stalemate where you can't move any further until you make two choices. Or one of two choices. Or even anymore. Because you're going to be in your head. I'm thinking that's what the stalemate is. But whatever. But the good thing is you got a magician right here. So you got all the tools you need. You got the pentacles, the cups, the wands, and the swords to manifest your way out of that. You got everything you need, all the elements you need. That's what I'm thinking. The two choices I think is like to stay in your head about this or to manifest your way out of it, which is obviously the right choice, right? What do we got in the way you're influencing this? Influencing it. Oh, this one, these two. Okay, so the truth and the three cups. The Lord of Abundance. So this is like celebrating something, like maybe the completion of something. This is the truth or clarity, but most likely the truth. So some truth is coming out here. You're going to bring some truth to to the environment. Or truth is the way you're influencing the situation, so that's a good way. So that could be what all this conflict's about. Maybe somebody doesn't want that truth to get out, right? Three cups could be like celebrating, some celebrating the completion, maybe of like finally finding the truth or something. Hopes and fears for Aquarius. Okay, four of cups. So you go from the three of cups to the four of cups. this is your hopes or fears. This is probably your hopes and your fears a little bit, because blended pleasure is like up, like roller coaster, up and down, up and down. So it's good one day, it's bad. It's good that one day, it's like blended pleasure, right? Cancerian energy. What do we got in the lens you're looking through? Lens you're looking through, Aquarius. Lens. Ooh. Well, I need one. I'll take that. Seven of Pentacles, Lord of Success Unfulfilled. Okay. So you're looking at it as if you didn't give enough. Like you ran the football all the way down to the 5-yard line and got tackled by it, like some big bastard ran your face right into the turf, and you're like, shit, I was like 2 yards away. So that's the way you're looking at it. So maybe you felt like you came up a little short. It happens to everybody, right? How many sevens you got here so far? Is that a seven? That's an eight. Okay, good. Seven. Yeah, so you get two sevens. Two sevens, okay, so far we only got two sevens. So if we make one. Yeah. Okay. We got one more 7 minutes of warning. So I'm expecting it because of the first card out there. That's the choosing a warning in itself, right? When you get those cards together. These two in the environment. Princess of Pentacles, so possibly a younger Earth sign, a younger student of something, and an Ace of Cups, so that's like a new love offer, possibly, or some kind of new love offer, or some kind of emotional win of some kind, or possibly a younger Earth sign, the Princess of the Echoing Hills. Princess of the Echoing Hills, yeah. So what's that? Two aces you got too. So that's pretty. Outcome is, what do we got in the outcome for Aquarius? Eight of Pentacles. Okay, that's enough. That's the Lord of Prudence. What else we got here? These two? Yeah, I'll take these two. 6 of cups. So nostril gel, you might need to blow your nose because you might have some nostril gel. Or you could be thinking of the good old days. This one come out reversed. The 8 of swords. Ooh. 8 of swords reversed is good though. Because it come out reversed. 8 of swords this way is Lord of Short and Force. But it's, I think when it's, it comes out this way, it's reversed, so it's better. So nostril gel, Lord of Prudence. And I'm going to look that one up. 8 of swords reversed. Reversed is treachery, difficulty, disquiet, and accident. So be careful. You could have an accident. Yeah, just be careful. Make sure you, anything you do, just be careful. Because you never know when this Yahoo is going to come out and rush you too, right? So, nostalgia, Lord of Prudence, Seven of Pentacles, Eight of Pentacles. Overly careful in small things at the expense of the great. Pennywise and pound foolish, gain ready money in small sums. Apprenticeship. Okay. So that's twice as apprentice, because this one kind of means apprenticeship too, right? The Page of Pentacles. So. Or like a student. So you might be learning something new. How many eights do you got? Eight. Okay. Only 2 8, so that's okay. But an underlying energy, just when I said that, the third eight. Eight is actually, you might want to look that up. I can't remember off the top of my head. I know Golden Dawn is 888. Because that's the year they were formed or whatever, but 1888, but 8 usually means infinity, right? It's the infinity sign, so it could be like triple infinity. It's definitely an angel number. I would look it up. I can't remember what it is off the top of my head, but I'll look it, if I was you, I'd look up 888 to see what that angel number means, because that's probably significant. There's not another 7, is there? Okay. 8. Holy shit, yeah, 4 8s. So yeah, definitely look that up. That's definitely an angel number. 8888. That's every 8 in the deck you got. So that's very significant. I would look it up if I was you. Have a good one, Aquarius. Oh, wait. I was going to pull a... I keep on forgetting to do that. I'm going to pull a... where's this stick again? These goddess and goddess god, your oracle cards. I'm going to start pulling one of these for everybody's reading too. So let's see what goddess you get. Let's give it a quick shuffle now. Oshun, sweet success. Right on. That's a good one. I think they're all good, actually. Let's see what it says about it. This is Oshun, sweet success. Oshun. There we go. Oshun. Is the mother of the Nigerian Yoruba people, and her name means the source. She is Orisha, a spiritual protector sent by Supreme Creator Odulamar. This beloved goddess holds the keys to fertility, success, and prosperity. Women pray to her to help them get pregnant. The patron saint of the Osun River, Oshun's great flowing waters, can cure illness, grant wishes, and confer protection to women leaders. Her colors are yellow and amber. Some of her symbols are brass bracelets, honey peacocks, sunflowers, and pumpkins. Are you secretly afraid of being richly rewarded and successful? Were you taught that life and work are struggles to be endured? It is difficult for you to equate spiritual service with material wealth and social status. You've been working hard for a long time, and Ashuni Yoruba, goddess of creation, has been watching you. She sees your efforts and knows what it takes to juggle countless demands alongside creating meaningful work. You're a sacred feminine creator in tune with the source of all things, says Ashuni. The time has come for your creations to be birthed with ease, just as I gave birth to the first people on earth. She declares, leading you to a river gushing with energy of prosperity. Release thoughts of lack in Ocean's flowing waters. It's important that you do this as the universe is moving you into positions of leadership. Allow yourself to be richly resourced and wildly successful in all your creations. Old beliefs about scarcity and patterns of undervaluing your time and energy are being washed away by Ashun's river. Wealth in all forms flows in you. Claim your throne of divine feminine influence and lead with love. Additional meanings is what you are inquiring about will be successful. A promotion or leadership position is within your reach. Increase what you charge for your services. Work on limiting beliefs about money. This is a positive message about pregnancy or adoption. Invocation is my creations generate rich rewards. I accept sweet success. So that's your oracle.